Amen, church. Hallelujah. Wala kang katulad, Panginoon. Indeed, Panginoon, wala kang katulad. All glory and honor belongs to the Lord, church. Good and blessed morning. Are we enjoying the day? Are we enjoying the morning? Amen. I don't know if you have it, but I just feel that joy in my heart. Do you have that joy in your heart right now? Mga kapatid, there are a lot of millionaires and trillionaires and billionaires all over the world trying to pursue, trying to chase for that joy. But some reason, that joy is very elusive. Amen? They might have a million in their bank, but their next goal is how to turn that to a second million. They might have a billion in their bank, but they are very stressed because they are not listed in the richest man in the world. But my dear brothers and sisters, being in the house of the Lord, being in the presence of the Lord brings that joy. Amen? Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Let us pray. Most gracious Lord and Heavenly Father, Father, we know and we do believe, Father God, that this joy in our hearts, O Lord, cannot be hidden from you. And Lord, this joy in our hearts cannot be contained, Father, cannot be extinguished, Father God. And Lord, we can only thank you. We thank you so much, Father. We cannot help but to thank you. We cannot help but to glorify you and honor you. We cannot help, Father God, but to look up to you, Father, for you are the source of that joy in our heart. Lord, we thank you not because of our luck. We thank you not because of the things that we do not have. We thank you not because of our illnesses and sicknesses. We thank you not because of our problems. But we thank you, Father, that in spite of all this, there is that joy in our heart. And Father God, it is our prayer that as we continue to study your words today, it is our prayer that as we continue to follow in the footstep of your Son Jesus, may we be able to follow him with that joy in our heart. It is not without any challenges and tribulations. Your Son Jesus Christ himself said, in this world, there will be trials and tribulations that will come to test you, that will come to pin you down, that will come to make you quit. But Jesus as well said, but take heed, have peace in me, have that joy in me, because I have overcome all this. Thank you very much, Father. Father, we pray for the sanctifying blood of your Holy Spirit. Lord, sanctify your word. We pray, Father God, that whatever words that will come out from this pulpit is touched and anointed by you. Father, I am just your mouthpiece, Father God. I personally pray that none of me will be considered, Father. Not my stature, not my build. None of me will be considered, Father God, but Lord, the words that you have given me. So pray, Father, for my brothers and sisters, both the people gathered here and people tuning in online, give them that receptive heart. Holy Spirit, move upon them. Holy Spirit, steer their heart so that they have that joy to receive your word. But I pray as well for them to have that willingness to go away and test these words, O God, and personally receive the revelation that comes from you. Thank you very much. We take every works and wiles in the schemes of the enemy that is trying to hinder us right now, and we declare the blood of Jesus, we declare the victory, and we declare the joy in listening and hearing your words this morning. This is our prayer in Jesus' mighty name. And all the people of God says, Amen. Hallelujah. Are we enjoying the company in the presence of the Holy Spirit this morning, church? Amen. Hallelujah. And thank you to all the lives of the music team that the Lord has used today and all the life of the other brothers and sisters who stood here and exhorted, the life of young Glyza, last minute change for the special number. May the Lord God bless you all. Hallelujah. So my dear brothers and sisters, let us continue our series on resolution. Amen. And as it is the third Sunday, we now know that when we say resolution, what we really meant is our firm decision. So meaning, we came into the Lord by first having that firm decision. Amen. We came to the Lord, we became Christian, we became who we are today because we believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, John 3:15, Romans 10:9. Amen. That having that firm decision to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ in His complete work of salvation in the cross, my dear brothers and sisters, no? We know that firm resolution that we have done is solid, is immovable, is uninfluencable. Amen. So really, in layman's term, no turning back. Amen. Firm yung decision mo eh. So when you decide to follow Jesus, no turning back. Amen. And on the first Sunday, we talk about our firm decision to develop, to secure and grow in our worship. Amen. God in the center, God in the middle, a worship that honors and glorifies the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. I cannot help to declare and I cannot help state that we indeed had a truly awesome and amazing worship this morning, my dear brothers and sisters. Amen. If you did not encounter that, if you did not find that, maybe your mind or your thoughts is somewhere else. Hallelujah. Last Sunday, we talked about the resolution about following in the footstep of Jesus. And this Sunday, today, part two. Amen? Are we ready, church? Tell the brothers and sisters around you, are you ready to follow in the footstep of Jesus? Hallelujah. Amen? Our anchor passage is 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 21. It says in there, to this reason you were called, because Christ suffered for you, leaving you an example that you should follow in His footstep. Amen, church. So, you were called. The fact that you call yourself Christian, the fact that you call yourself the follower of Jesus, that means, my dear brothers and sisters, you were called. Amen? And who called us? Jesus, our Lord Jesus. Amen? And by Him calling us, He is qualified to call us because He says in there, He suffered for us. Amen? He suffered for us. So He is very qualified. And by calling us, He said that He also set an example. And what are we to do on that example, my dear brothers and sisters? We ought to follow in that example. Amen? Hallelujah. So my dear brothers and sisters, today, I want us to contemplate. I want us to look into how can I follow in the footstep of Jesus? Because it says in here that Christ suffered for us, and as a result, we are called to follow in that example that He gave us. And what are we to do in that example? We are to follow in His footstep, no? So yung tanong is, how can we follow in His footstep? What are the ways? Ano po yung mga kaparaanan for us to be able to follow His footstep? Amen? So what I want us to do is, with our time, let us reflect on the characteristic of our Lord Jesus, His life in ministry while He was here in this earth, and how can we follow? How can we emulate? Paano po natin yung magaya? Amen po. So number one, my dear brothers and sisters, if you read the word of the Lord, especially in that gospel where the work, life, and ministry of our Lord Jesus is. If you read Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, you will not fail to notice kung ano, what is Jesus's priority. Amen. What is Jesus's priority? So as a believer, as a Christian, my dear brothers and sisters, I want us to follow in the priority of Jesus. I want us to follow in the level of commitment na meron si Jesucristo. Amen, church? What is Jesus's priority? Anyone? God is Jesus's priority. God is Jesus's priority. His desire and commitment and serving God. No? Everything that Jesus do, there is only one meaning and purpose, and that is serving God. Amen. Serving the will of the Father. Amen, church. And sabi ko nga, this is very evident. At a very early age, at the very early age, mga kapatid, if you look at your Bible and Luke chapter 2, verse 49, Luke chapter 2, verse 49, my dear brothers and sisters, no? It says in here, "Why were you searching for me?" he asked his parents. "Didn't you know that I had to be in my Father's house?" No? This is the time that when a young Jesus, 12 years old, it's very safe to say that kaedad ng mga boys na to. Boys, are you listening? So Jesus would have been in the same age as you when his parents brought him to the temple to worship the Lord. And all of a sudden, they noticed, they realized that Jesus is not around. Jesus is not with them. So they look for Jesus. And maybe they are worried because it's getting late. You know, I remember, we used to have a farm in Umingan, Pangasinan. And I used to go there as a holiday. And in that farm, I have a lot of memories of that farm, really. And in that farm, my dear brothers and sisters, when they go to market, they call it Udong or Market Day. When they go to Udong or Market Day, there's only like few batches of kuliglig that goes to the marketplace. Na kung ano yung nasakyan mo ng umaga, yun din yung masasakyan mo ng tanghali. Otherwise, if you miss that, no? You have to hire yourself a tricycle. And dahil malubak, syempre yung tricycle has to increase the price. So pretty much the same siguro. Siguro sabi ni Joseph and Mary, "Oh, we are to go back to Nazareth. And the caravan is leaving, so where is Jesus?" And to their amazement, they found Jesus in the middle of assembly, talking, conferring, sharing with the teachers of the law. And we can say, my dear brothers and sisters, that even the teachers of the law, namangha po sila about the gifting, about the knowledge of this Jesus boy. And sabi nga ni Sister Cherry kanina, if you are in the presence of the Lord, if you dwell in the presence of the Lord, para kang magnet. Amen. "The wisdom of the Lord is upon me," Jesus said. And the parents said that, "Oh, Jesus, why did you wander off?" Siguro sabi nila, "Bakit ka gumala? Bakit ka nagpauli-uli?" "Jesus, we will be late going home. Jesus, why did you do this to us?" But what did Jesus said? Sabi niya sa binasa natin, "Why were you searching for me?" He asked them. "Didn't you know that I had to be in my Father's house?" In King James translation, it says in there, "Didn't you know that I am supposed to be doing my Father's business?" Amen. So my dear brothers and sisters, priority. Makikita natin kung ano what is Jesus's priority. Amen. Maybe your boss approach you. Mr., Mrs., there is an overtime on Saturday. Sunday pala. And what ought to be the reply? Boss, didn't you know that it is Sunday? I must be about in my Father's house. Amen? I must be about in my Father's business. Amen, church? Puyat ako, hirap akong gumising. Masakit ang ulo ko. I have a headache. I cannot go to the church. You remember, my dear brothers and sisters, when Peter's mother-in-law is afflicted with fever, Jesus rebuked the spirit of fever. So whatever it is that you are experiencing, there is a spirit that is pressing down on it. And when you wake up Sunday morning, you're having a headache. When you wake up Sunday morning, you're having a stomach ache. The enemy that will put in your mind, it is reasonable. It is a blessing. Hindi mo kailangang pumunta sa church ngayon. But my dear brothers and sisters, rebuke that headache. And say, headache, I rebuke you. Did you not know that I must be in the house of the Father? Amen, church? Plano, lakad. Oy, plano, kita-kita ang mga magkakaibigan. Oy, my sales supports mo, especially Sunday today, punta tayo doon. My dear brothers and sisters, tell them, do you not know that I must be about my Father's house? Amen, church. You know what I challenge you today? Who amongst us works on your diary? May I have to have a diary, because if I don't do a diary, sometimes I forget na may pasok pala ako, nakabihis na ako, and then I will check, and then wala akong clinic. Yun pala, day off. So I use diary. Do you use diary, church? You know my challenge to you? Especially New Year, new diary. My challenge to you when you go home, go cross out all the Sundays. Because you know why? So that when you're planning, you're booking something, you should not be booking on those Sundays. Because you know why? That day is not for you. That day on your appointment is non-existent. That day belongs to the Lord. The Lord said, I gave you 6 days to do everything that you please. But on the Lord's appointed day, in the Lord's Sunday, holiday, allocate that for me. Amen. Do not allocate 2 hours to come to the church. No. Full day is 23.59 seconds. 23 hours and 59 seconds. Amen. No, 24 hours. So my dear brothers and sisters, what is our priority? Amen. Sitting here this morning, can we truly make at peace with our spirit? Can we truly make at peace with the Lord, putting our hand in our chest where our heart is and say, Lord, if you look at my heart, you cannot deny that you are my priority. Are we able? Are we in that position to tell that? That is the challenge, church. Amen, church? Amen. Hallelujah. And kung titignan natin sa John chapter 4, in John chapter 4, who can remember what is the highlight of that John chapter 4? Samaritan woman. Amen. This is the time when Jesus and his disciples were going to Galilee, and they were tired and they toured to this place called Samaria. Amen. And Jesus told his disciples, okay, you go ahead in the town and buy Jollibee. I will wait here in the well. Usually the well is outside the town. Amen. So as he was sitting outside, there is the purpose. Because why? After a while, eventually, there is this Samaritan woman who come to draw water. And my dear brothers and sisters, Jesus was there resting. Nagpapahinga si Kristo. Amen? He was resting by the well. And while he was resting, opportunity knocks. Hindi OT, ah. A soul came. Amen? A soul came, and Jesus started to witness to this woman. Jesus started to share the word of God to this woman. And in the beginning, the woman is resistant. Diba, nagkaroon nga sila ng konting change of overview, change of understanding. But Jesus was very persistent. Jesus was very persistent, and he was able to share the word of God to this woman, so that eventually, this woman believed. Amen. So mga kapatid, Jesus was about to rest, or Jesus is resting. But when the business of the Father came, an opportunity, ginawa niya yung opportunity. Amen. Sabi ni Sister Michelle on Friday, my dear brothers and sisters, in good times or bad times, let us praise and worship the Lord. Amen. In season or out of season, we need to preach the word of God. Masama man ang pakiramdam mo, if you have the opportunity, share. Amen. Hallelujah. And what happened, my dear brothers and sisters? This woman went to the villages and he testified to the people, come, mga kababayan ko, come and see this man who told me everything that I have done. He should be the Messiah. And my dear brothers and sisters, these people came to Jesus and they start to listen to the word teaching of Jesus, my dear brothers and sisters. Jesus is tired, Jesus is resting, but when the opportunity comes, he grabbed the opportunity to share to the life of the woman, to the life of this community. Amen? But my dear brothers and sisters, when the disciples came back, who went to bought Jollibee, and they brought the food, and they say, Jesus, tama na muna yan. Pahinga na muna. Kumain na muna tayo. And what did Jesus answer, my dear brothers and sisters? In verse 29, Jesus said, my dear brothers and sisters, verse 34. Jesus said, my food is to do the will of him who sent me and to finish his work. Amen. Jesus is tired. Jesus is hungry. But his priority take precedent. And ano yung priority niya? To do the will of God. To do the will of the Father. Wow. Nakikita po ba natin yung commitment na yan, my dear brothers and sisters? Amen? Nakikita po ba natin yung commitment na yan? My food is to do the will of my Father, to do the will of God. Amen, church? Do we share the same commitment? Amen, church? So dito, pagod si Kristo, Jesus is tired, Jesus is hungry, pero inuna niya yung the work of the Father. Amen. And my dear brothers and sisters, I do apologize, but I can't seem to help but to notice, no? When we come to church, what is our priority? What is our purpose? Anyone? To worship the Lord. To do the will of the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. And our worship, our service begins when we step in here and music prepare begins when we go there and sanctify, and it ends when we say amen at the end. Amen. So from now on, wala po sanang hindi pa tapos yung service. Nagpapainit na ng pagkain dun. No? Food is not part of our service. That is adjunct. That is extra. And we have a privilege to enjoy that, mga kapatid. Amen. But remember when we were in Aldershot, we finished the service before we all go to the house of Ate Grace. So what's the difference in here? Amen. Let's prioritize the Lord. Let's prioritize the work of the Lord. Amen, church? Amen. Hindi naman po yata masamang idea yun. Amen po. Hallelujah. Amen po. And we can see in John 8:29. Amen. We can see in John 8:29. Sabi niya doon, mga kapatid, if you have your Bible, take down notes. The one who sent me is with me. He has not left me alone. Why? For he always do what pleases him. Amen. So Jesus said that the Father who sent me is with me. Amen. In these things, my dear brothers and sisters, they are written for our purposes and benefit. Remember, Jesus left an example and we are to follow. In these passages, it is not only for us to read. It is only for, it is also for us to embody. So it is also for us to claim. Amen. We can claim that. That the one who sent me has not left me alone. Amen. Because I always do His will. Amen, church, mga kapatid, no? So if we can see, this is very personal to Jesus. And makikita natin that very personal ginagawa niyo po kung ano yung kalooban ng Ama. Amen. He does what pleases the Father. Amen. So my dear brothers and sisters, ito yung motivation ni Christ. The motivation of Christ, the motivation of Jesus Christ in going on. Amen. If ever you are tired, just remember this, that motivation. That Jesus, that God who put you there is always with you. Amen. Because He is always with you, He will not leave you alone. Amen. In order for us to be able to be in that position and capacity to do what pleases Him. Jesus was tired, Jesus was hungry, but His motivation is to do the will of the Father, is to do what pleases Him. Amen, church. Hallelujah. So the question now being, hang on, what is my motivation? Amen. What is our motivation? What is our aim in life? Is that aim in life Christ-centered? Is that aim in life Christ-glorifying? Or is that aim is more of a personal gain, personal benefit and interest? Is that motivation in life is material? Is that motivation in life earthly gain? Or is that motivation in life is a temporary gain? My dear brothers and sisters, if we examine the Word of God, Jesus did not seek to please Himself. Amen? Jesus did not please to seek Himself, but He always pleases, He always seek to do the will of the Father, for this pleases Him. Amen, church? Hallelujah? Hallelujah? Nadadagdagan ba natin, or our priority, our commitment is being awakened up? Amen, church. I pray for that receptive heart, mga kapatid, upang sa ganun, we can all receive the Word of God. Amen po? Luke 14:26, it says in here, if anyone comes to me, and does not hate his father and mother, does not hate his wife and children, does not hate his brothers and sisters, yes, does not even hate his own life, he cannot be my disciple. Wow, my dear brothers and sisters, amen. If you choose to come to the Lord, and you do not hate your parents. You do not hate your husband and wife. You do not hate your children. You do not hate the world. You do not hate even your own self, sabi ng Panginoon. You are not fit to be my disciple. Amen, church? Bakit? Amen? Hello? Amen? I know you're sitting in there and to be honest, this God is brutal. I don't agree. Because hate is a very strong word. Amen, church? Hate is a very strong word. That's the importance of applying exegesis in the principle of exegesis, which is hermeneutics. We talked about that last Friday. My dear brothers and sisters, this word hate is brutal. I do not agree with that as well. But if you actually go back to the original translation, the original word used in here is the Greek word meseo, which means loveless, which means revereless. The English word hate is very brutal. But if you actually look at the Greek word, it says in there, loveless. It says in there, revereless, my dear brothers and sisters. Amen? It only means, my dear brothers and sisters, that our highest love, that our highest reverence is for God. Amen? It does not use the concept of English word hate. Amen? It only means that our priority is God. Amen, church? Just like Jesus. Amen? Hallelujah. Let's reconcile the room. Because I can see that there's a lot of not convinced in that. Husband or wife, who are we going to use as an example? Ay, tinuro kayo. Tinuro kayo. Sister Alma, tinuro kayo nung nasa likod niyo eh. Example, Sister Alma, how many percent of love you want Brother Lester to give you? Choose a number, 1 to 100. How many percent? Huh? No. How many percent? 1 to 100? Huh? If you are to ask me, I'm not gonna settle less than 100. Amen. If you are gonna ask me, I'm not gonna settle less than 100. I want my wife to love me 100%. Amen, church. Amen. Do we agree with that? In husband, you, even Brother Lester, he will not agree to receive a love less than 100%. Amen? Church? Amen? So, our portion is 100%. Amen? But is there anyone stopping you, wife? Is there anyone stopping you, husband, to love the Lord 200%? Anyone? No. Magre-reklamo ba si wife? Inatatanggap naman niya yung 100% na portion niya. Amen. So the wife will not, hindi magre-reklamo maski ibigay ni husband yung 1,000 love niya sa Lord. Kasi at the end of the day, you receive your 100% portion. That's what the passage means. Amen. That's what the passage meant. When it says in there that loveless, hindi niya sinabing, it did not mean that you reduce the love. You reduce your love to your parents. You reduce the love to your husband and wife. You reduce the love to your sibling. You reduce the love to yourself. That's not what the Bible meant. Only what the Bible meant is the way you love your parents, the way you love your husband and wife, the way you love your siblings, the way you love yourself, you ought to love the Lord more than that. Amen. 101%. Hallelujah. Amen, church. No? So dito makikita natin that hopefully after listening to that na our priority is shaping up. Amen po? Amen? That if our priority prior to today is the Lord, our commitment is on the roof, pray that after confirming the step after confirming yung attitude ng life in ministry ni Jesus about his priority in commitment na let us continue on that path. Amen, church? Hallelujah? Amen? So if we are to be asked, who is our priority? Are we in agreement? Amen. Hallelujah. Number two is prayerfulness. Sister Cherry did not go on short in exhorting us about prayerfulness earlier. Amen. And my dear brothers and sisters, if we examine the Bible, I know that we have read the Bible already. If you have already read the Bible from cover to cover, maybe it's about time to examine it, meaning go deeper. Amen. So when we examine the Bible, we cannot fail to notice that Jesus is prayerful. That Jesus is only able to operate. Jesus is only able to give that priority. Jesus was only able to give that commitment because he is prayerful. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, the backbone of our relationship with the Lord, the backbone of our faith in the Lord. What is the backbone of your relationship, husband and wife? Communication. Amen. Thank you. Gaano man kamahal ng isang tao, ang isang tao, alat fail. LDR kasi. Hindi makapag-communicate. So we end up separating. Ang lapit lang. But she always go to work Monday to Sunday. When in fact, if you look at yourself, you do the same. So there is no communication. So my dear brothers and sisters, the backbone of every relationship is communication. And what is prayer? Communicating with God. Amen. So, how can you be a Christian if you are distant with the Father? How can you be a Christian if you do not communicate with the Father? If you do not tell the Father what do you think and you do not receive from the Father what does He want, my dear brothers and sisters? So, prayerfulness. In here, my dear brothers and sisters, malinaw na malinaw, we can see that Jesus was only able to do what he has to do because he was in constant communication with the Father. Amen, church? Amen? What is the use of having a strong hands to raise during worship? What is the use of having a strong hand, technically skilled? What is the use of having an agile legs to dance and jump during worship if your spine, your backbone is weak? Paralyzed pa rin. Hindi pa rin makatayo. Amen. So the same thing with our faith in the Lord. There is no use of filled with gift, manifestation, if we are not prayerful. Amen. So with this, my dear brothers and sisters, I challenge us all. I challenge us all. Trade your talent and skills to prayer. Trade your Facebook time to prayer. Trade those many idols that you have to prayer. Sabi nga kanina again, if you are prayerful, para kang magnet. Amen. The thing that you disregard, a greater thing will come. Amen? Prayerful. Hallelujah. So makikita natin, my dear brothers and sisters, that Jesus Christ was constantly praying. Amen? So meaning, this is unrefutable example. This is undeniable example na gusto rin ni Kristo, tayo bilang Kristiyano, tayo bilang disipulo, mananampalataya ay madasalin. Amen. It is vitally important in our life as a Christian. Amen, church? If you are a Christian and you are not prayerful, it's as if, sabi nga, gasgas na litanya, a sundalo that is placed in the middle of war without gun. Amen. It's as if a musician without a guitar, without a drumstick, without those keyboards. Amen, church? Hallelujah. So let us be prayerful. It is very important because in Matthew chapter 6, Jesus taught us the model prayer. Amen? Why did Jesus taught us model prayer? What is the reason? So that we can do it. So that we can pray it. Amen, church? Paano mo tuturuan yung bata para maging masunurin? Para maging masunurin sa'yo. So same thing that Jesus taught us the model prayer in order for us to pray. Amen? You can find that in Matthew 6 and Luke 11. Amen? God as well taught us that the Father honors the motive of our heart. The Father considers the state of our heart in praying rather than the way we pray, rather than the words that we say. Amen. Diba? Sa Luke 11, he gave the contrast of how those Pharisees are praying and how someone who is praying behind closed doors. Aling prayer po doon yung ino-honor ng Panginoon? Matthew 6, I mean. Anong prayer doon yung ino-honor ng Panginoon? With that contrite heart behind closed doors. Amen? Luke 11, Jesus told us as well to continue to pray. Ask, and it shall be given unto you. Seek, and you shall find. Knock, and it will be open unto you. Amen? For everyone who asks will be given, everyone who seek will find, and everyone who knock will be opened to. Amen, my dear brothers and sisters. Amen? 1 Thessalonians 5, 16 to 18, rejoice always. Pray continually. Give thanks in all circumstances. Amen, church? Pray continually. For this is God's will for us in Christ Jesus. Amen, church. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, dahil you are teaching us again. You're revisiting, Father. You're implanting again, Father God, in our heart to be prayerful. Amen. So later on, we will just announce few things. In there, we can find out that we will be allocating other people. We will be tweaking the service a little bit. We will be allocating people to lead the opening prayer. Amen. And the challenge to you, my dear brothers and sisters, being prayerful is, habang ipinag-pre-pray ni Pastor, i-allocate kung sino yung mag-lead ng prayer, Lunes pa lang, nagtitext na, Pastor, ako ang i-allocate mo sa opening prayer. Amen, church. There is power in being prayerful. Amen. Hallelujah. So I will make sure that I will silent my mobile phone on Monday because I know a lot of you will message and say, Pastor, ako na ang i-allocate mong mag-opening prayer this Sunday. Amen. Prayerful. Hallelujah. Let's move on. Mga kapatid, what is the quality of Jesus Christ that we need to follow? Purity. Wow. Purity. Hallelujah. Amen. Purity. 1 John 1:7, it says in there, if we walk in the light as He is in the light, actually, Jesus is the light of the world. Amen. If we walk in the light as He is in the light, we have fellowship with one another. Wow. That is pala the true fellowship. You know, when we say that, oh, I am going to the church to fellowship with my brothers and sisters, in order for that fellowship pala to materialize, we all ought to be walking in the light. Because Jesus himself, I mean, the word of the Lord himself says that what fellowship does darkness has with light? That's the importance, my dear brothers and sisters, that ministers, that before we begin, I challenge you, I urge you, your priority, your commitment, when you enlisted yourself, when you were called, my dear brothers and sisters, is to be able to minister unrestrictedly. That's the importance of sanctification. Dahil we are not perfect. You know, we pray, we came here, practice Saturday night. Amen. And up until that following Sunday morning, it's a very wide range of time for us to be able to be enticed by the enemy. So it is very important that before we come and stand in the front, the last thing that we do is sanctify. Amen. Because that is the only way that fellowship will flow. If people in front is walking in the light. Same thing with you, church. Do not be late, because always, the opening prayer, we always ask the Lord sanctification. So in order for you to come to the presence of the Lord, we ought to be walking in the light. Amen. Or I challenge you, I urge you, you're probably doing it already. As you depart in your house and come to church on the way, why don't just pray? Why don't just sing hymns? Amen. Sunday starts at home, not in the church. Amen, church? Hallelujah. So purity. We can only have that fellowship with one another if we walk in the light. Because our fellowship foundation is the light. Amen. And how can we be in the light when in fact we were in darkness? It says in there, the blood of Jesus cleanses us from all this darkness that is brought by this sin. Amen. So my dear brothers and sisters, I believe that we can agree that light is a symbol of purity. Amen. Jesus is the light of the world. Jesus is pure. Amen. Do we agree that Jesus is pure? Yes, because that's the Bible, what the Bible says. 1 Peter 1:22. He committed no sin and no deceit was found in his mouth. Amen. Jesus committed no sin. No deceit was found in his mouth. Amen. We can see that during Jesus' ministry, Jesus was pure in his mind. Jesus was pure in his action. Jesus is pure in his speech. Amen. Leaving us a perfect example. Amen, church. Jesus is leaving us a perfect example to follow, to be purified. Especially as we live in these last days. We learned last Friday that Apostle Paul prophesied and warned us, 2 Timothy chapter 3, that these last days will come. And on the same Friday, we put few scriptures from James to confirm that we are indeed in the last days, my dear brothers and sisters. Amen. These are the last days. And it says in there, what happened in the last days? People will be impure. Godlessness will increase. The love of many will grow cold. People will not want to live in the light, but they prefer to stay in the dark. Amen, my dear brothers and sisters. That is the warning of Timothy and Apostle Paul. No? So my dear brothers and sisters, no? What do we have to do during these times? What do we need to do during these perilous times, my dear brothers and sisters? 2 Corinthians 5:21, it says in there, God made him, or Jesus, God made Jesus, who had no sin, to be sin for us, so that in Him we might become the righteousness of God. We are living in the last days. These are the last days. But my dear brothers and sisters, if the world is godless, if in the eyes of many darkness is found in them, you know what is happening now? And you go back to Genesis, and you read during that time when God decided to flood the earth. The reason is God said, when I look at the eyes of man, I cannot see nothing but darkness. What is happening now? Is that not the same? Look at the sin of the world during the time of Noah and compare it now. To be honest, it is worse now. We are in the last days, my dear brothers and sisters. If you examine the Bible, there is no prophecy that needs to be fulfilled. All prophecy has already been fulfilled. The only big thing that follows now, my dear brothers and sisters, is the day of our Lord. Amen. The day of our Lord. So my dear brothers and sisters, during these last days, during these days where godlessness increase, these days will people turn away from God. My dear brothers and sisters, we ought to recommit ourselves and follow the footstep of Jesus in purity. Amen. Church, mapagod na po tayo sa mga rason, sa mga katagang pasensya na, tao lang, reasonable na magkasala. My dear brothers and sisters, let us not continually crucify Christ by continually sinning. Huwag po sanang ganun. Our license, our salvation is not a license to sin. Amen. So we must be a people of purity. As Jesus Christ is our God, we follow in His footstep. Amen, mga kapatid. Hallelujah. And number four is perseverance. Nababanggit uli, no? I realize. I only realize now na four piece pala ito. I did not realize it before now. Four piece pala ito. Priority, prayerfulness, purity, and perseverance. Honestly, I did not realize na four piece pala ito. Otherwise, binigyan sana natin ng title na four piece. Or ayuda. Ayuda ito galing sa Panginoon. Amen, church? Ito ang ayuda natin sa Panginoon ngayong linggong ito. Amen? And number four is perseverance. Again, nababanggit ulit. In our study last Friday, sino yung nag-comment na, wow, I think yung message, the encouragement is lumalabas yung perseverance. Who is that? You remember Ate Grace? No? Sabi ni Ate Grace, wow, yung message is about perseverance, lumalabas about perseverance. Nababanggit ulit. And I came to realize na, bakit mga kapatid? Why perseverance? Saan po apply yung encouragement na persevere? Sa finish line. Amen? A runner who started to run, you will not encourage him to persevere. Your encouragement is quick, quick, quick. Amen? No, pay attention. If there is a race and they start to run, you don't encourage them to persevere. You encourage them to quick, faster, faster. But when they are now at the end, when all the runners are tired, when all the runners are on the verge of giving up, that's the time that you encourage them to persevere, persevere. Kaya mo yan. Push pa. Sige pa. Amen. So that's the reason why na bakit pala perseverance palagi na lang yung mensahe sa atin. Because again, we are living in the end days. If there is a preacher if there is a Christian in a speaker that will preach that we are not yet in the end days, then let them be declared a false teacher, to be honest. We are in the end days, my dear brothers and sisters. Balibaliktarin man natin ang salita ng Panginoon. We are in the end days. Amen. We are near the end of our race. Amen, mga kapatid. Amen. And what is the end of our race? Where is that finish line? The day of our Lord Jesus Christ. Hebrews chapter 1, verse, Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1 to 3. Therefore, since we are surrounded, by the way, let's start at verse 2 para maintindihan natin. It says in here, let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and the perfecter of our faith, who for the joy set before him endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand throne of God. Amen. So my dear brothers and sisters, in this race, as we are being encouraged to persevere, as we are nearing the end of that race, we are being encouraged to focus our eyes in Jesus. Amen? Because Jesus is the one who authored that race. Jesus is the one who perfected that race. Amen? And by doing that, sabi niya ron, he persevered. He endured. Amen? Scorning its shame. And by doing that, he completed the race and sat down in the right-hand throne of God. My dear brothers and sisters, do you realize that we have the joy in our heart? Because why? Because Jesus started and finished the race. Meaning, Jesus marked out the race. Meaning, Jesus laid the rules and regulations. Amen. By the looks of it now, you become a member of Patafa, you don't even know the rules and regulation. Anytime it can change. You watch the grand finale of Formula One? The rules change. Those racers, they don't know what the rule is. But as a Christian, amen, try to join a marathon and say, gaano, how long is the marathon? No, just run and we will tell you as the race evolve. What is the rule? No, just run and we will tell you as the race evolve. You are running and someone, the marshal will come to you and say, you're disqualified, you're disqualified, you're disqualified. But my dear brothers and sisters, Jesus started the race, Jesus finished the race, and Jesus mark out the race. So meaning, mga kapatid, we know what is happening. There is nothing hidden from our eyes when we come to Jesus. Amen? So my dear brothers and sisters, the encouragement is, let us fix our eyes on Jesus because he has marked out the race for us. He has completed it. And he has shown us the reward. So the encouragement for us, my dear brothers and sisters, is let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that easily entangles, and let us also run with perseverance. Jesus ran with perseverance, so tayo din ought to run with perseverance. Verse 3, it says in here, consider him or Jesus who endured such opposition from sinful man so that you will not grow weary and lose heart. You persevere. Amen. You persevere so that you will not grow weary and lose heart. Amen, church. So my dear brothers and sisters, no? In here, napakalinaw that our Christian life is portrayed as a race. Amen. In this race, must run with perseverance, must run with endurance, mga kapatid. Amen. And in this life, especially these perilous and terrible times of the last days, mga kapatid, we are being encouraged to persevere. Amen po, mga kapatid. No? During this time, there are a lot of reason for us to give up. There are a lot of reason for us to get tired. There are a lot of reason for us to say, that's it. Manlamig muna ako. Huminto muna ako. Magpahinga muna ako. But my dear brothers and sisters, focus our eyes on Jesus, the author and the perfecter of our faith. Make Jesus our example. Amen. In the Garden of Gethsemane in Luke chapter 22, verse 42. Luke 22, verse 42. It says in there, Father, if you are willing, take this cup from me, yet not my will, but yours be done. Amen. Mga kapatid, we can see that Jesus, he was really bothered with this heaviness and he was really bothered this difficulty, and the human nature in Jesus is kicking in. Kaya nga sabi niya rito, Father, if you are willing, take this cup from me. But my dear brothers and sisters, the encouragement of the Lord from this pulpit is to persevere, to endure, to continue. Amen, church? If you are in the verge of losing hope, if you are tired, if you are ready to give up, if you are getting cold, if you are not enjoying it anymore, if there is no other option but to stop, if giving up is a very viable option, come to the Lord and cry to the Lord and say, Father, I am in the verge of giving up. I am in the verge of losing hope. But Lord, I need your endurance. I need your perseverance. For this is your will for me. Amen. Let your will be done, Lord. Father, if you are willing, take this cup away from me. Jesus said, this is my desire. But I know that your desire is not giving up. Amen. And I am here to do what pleases you. Amen, church. Hallelujah. Come to the Lord and say, not my will be done, Lord, but yours be done. Your will be done. Amen, church. So dito makikita natin, mga kapatid, no? Can I invite the music? I appreciate that we have dwelled in there for quite a while. Let's stop here, no? This is not an exhaustive list. Huwag nating sabihin na, is that the only way to follow Jesus? To be honest, marami pa po. And there are few more here that we have prepared. But my dear brothers and sisters, there are many ways in characteristic of Jesus. There are many ways to follow the footstep of Jesus. But I believe that as we encounter Jesus along the way, as we grow in our study, as we grow in His words, we will encounter more. Amen, church. So let's welcome back the music team and let's continue to worship the Lord. Amen. Let's stand up, church, and let us continue to worship the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Let's continue to be in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. The word of the Lord in 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 8, it says in here, hallelujah, be self-controlled and alert. Your enemy, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion, looking for someone to devour. Mga kapatid, brethren, people online, we all know that being a Christian is not easy. Children, as you start to grow in faith, you realize and you notice that being Christian is not easy. Being Christian, I do not have only to follow my parents, but I'm expected to follow what the Lord says as well. So we know, my dear brothers and sisters, that being a Christian is not easy. Because you know why? 1 Peter 5:8 says that the devil in his cohorts, yung mga kampo niya, are very busy serving God. It's like walking through a minefield. If you imagine walking through a minefield, there are surfaces that you need to avoid. You only have to step on the specific footpath. Because if you step, nagkamali ka, if you step otherwise, that mine, that landmine will explode. Sasabog. Amen. But the encouragement of the Lord last week and this week and following his footstep, Jesus said, take heart. Our Lord Jesus Christ left his footstep before us to follow. I saw a documentary between the war of North Korea and South Korea, and there is that demilitarized zone that separate them. Walang gwardiya. There is no guard in that. They do not have to guard with soldier in either side. Because you know why? That is filled with landmine. And if you are to sweep landmine, yung nangunguna, he needs to step there. Yung sumusunod, he needs to step in the same footstep. But sometimes, they explode. So as a Christian, we have been encouraged last week and this week to follow in the footstep of Jesus. There is no other way. My dear brothers and sisters, we are in the end of our race. And the prize is Jesus at the end, raring to offer his warm embrace and say, well done, my good and faithful disciple. Well done, my good and faithful servant. Come and share your master's happiness. Welcome home. Amen. So my dear brothers and sisters, we are challenged here today, as we have learned, to follow the footstep, the priority, the commitment, the prayerfulness, the purity, in the perseverance of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen, church. Follow the footstep of our Lord Jesus Christ and you will arrive safely home. Amen. Safely home. Our home is our heavenly dwelling abode in the presence of our Father. Amen, church. Tell that to people around you. Arrive safely home. Arrive safely home, music. Arrive safely home, youth. Arrive safely home, husbands and wives, people online. Arrive safely home. Let's follow the footstep of our Lord Jesus Christ and arrive safely home. May God bless you all. Let us worship the Lord, church. Thank you.
praises to the Lord, church. We have an awesome God. Enter into that commitment with the Lord. Lord, from now on, not my will but yours be done. Hallelujah. Father, not my will, but yours be done in my life. Father, instill in me that renewed commitment to prioritize you in everything that I do. To emulate your example of prayerfulness. To preserve my life worthy of your calling in purity. And to persevere in coming after you. Lord, without your Son Jesus Christ and His example, and footstep that He left for us to follow. Father God, we cannot do it. Father God, we cannot get where you are. But thank you very much for your many great mercies and grace. We thank you for your exceeding love, that though we are sinners, your Son Jesus Christ suffered and died for us. And through His death and resurrection, we were called to follow in His example. We will called to follow in His footstep. Lord, we know that it is not easy. We know, Father God, that it is not without any trials, challenges and tribulations. But Father, thank you, because we know and we do believe that you will never leave us nor forsake us. Thank you, Father, that though we walk in the valley in the shadow of this tribulation, though we walk in the middle and in the eyes of this chaos, we will not fear, for thou art with us, Father God. Your Holy Spirit is our company. Your words, Father God, is our reminder. In the life of your Son Jesus, set us an example for us. As He has started, we believe that He will perfect this faith that we have. And we believe, Father, that we are near the end. So we are called to persevere. Christians now are called persevere believers, Father God. Many, for various reasons, Father God, has gone tired. Many has stopped. And Father God, continue to encourage us to dwell in your light, to love the light, Father, because it is only there that we can have fellowship with you and our fellow men, Father God. Thank you, Lord, that on the last days, that on the last time, at the day of the great appearing of your Son Jesus, you will come back for your church, a church who sanctified their clothes, who washed their robes with the blood of the Lamb. And thank you very much for giving us that wonderful opportunity, Father God, to be sanctified, Father, continuously with the blood of your Son, Jesus. Thank you for gathering us today. Whatever it is that we have encountered, whatever it is that we have experienced, whatever the words, Father, that you have taught us today, Father, we pray that they may be guarded in our heart, that they may be guarded in our mind. And Father, we pray that they will be manifested in us. And Father, we pray that we will clothe and we will live a life of a servant, a disciple, a follower, Father God, truly following the footstep of your Son, Jesus. Thank you so much, Lord, even as we finish today. We pray, Holy Spirit, to be with upon each and everyone as we trek this world again, Father God, as we go back to the world, Father, with all this chaos, pandemic, Father, in disorder, as has been prophesied, Father God. We thank you because you protect us. We thank you, Father God, because you preserve us. We thank you, Lord, that though 10,000 will fall on our left hand side and 100,000 on our right hand side, we thank you so much, Lord, because with long life in prosperity, with your protection, you are gonna preserve your children, Father God. And not only to us, Father, but we and our household as well. We glorify you, we thank you, and we look forward in coming back next Sunday, Father God, to worship you, to honor you in the midst of your assembly. But meanwhile, Father, allow us to constantly communicate with you this week, Father God. This is our prayer. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Praise God, praise God. So ito lang po yung maging response natin sa ating Panginoon. Amen. Praise God. Once again, can we just give a clap of praise to our living God in this place? Hallelujah. Glory to your name. Glory to your name, oh God. First one. Yeah, the first one. Okay. Okay, come on, let us adore, worship the Lord once again as we end this worship from this service for today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord.
Come and rise.
And hallelujah, and give the glory to our Lord. Come on, can we just raise our hands once again? Come on, praise God.
All
glory, glory, glory to your name. Glory to your name. Praise God, praise God, praise God. Bless your name. We bless your name. We bless your name. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. God bless everyone.